Praise to the Trinitarian God. Praise to the God the Father, God the Son, and God the Spirit. All praise goes to the eternal Word of God. All praise goes to the Alpha and Omega, who is beginning and the end. Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
We love you, Jesus.
Lord Jesus Christ is identified as the Prince of Peace. It is Lord Jesus Christ who doesn't only offer peace to one another, but with his blood, he also offered peace between man and God. In the beginning, Bible tells us, man and woman sin against God. As man and woman sin against God, we are separated from God. Genesis chapter 3 gives us the solution for this sin, for this separation. Throughout Bible, God screams out what is the solution for the sin. It is the eternal Word of God. It is the Messiah who is going to come and lay his life down for the sinful mankind, for you, Lizzie, for me, and for everyone. And through blood of Lord Jesus Christ, who died on the cross, we are made right with God through our repentance. Bible tells us there is no any other way men and women can be in the presence of God unless they repented the blood of Lord Jesus Christ.
Otherwise, our sin is not paid for. And how on earth can we get back in the presence of a holy God unless our sin is dealt with?
This week, we remembered what happened in Manchester. 22nd of May 2017, 22 people were killed. 23 with the killers. So, 22 innocent people killed, and plus the bomber, 23 people's life has been taken away.
And 139 people wounded. This time last year, 5 days ago, on the 22nd of May.
That's a lot of number. As we remember and pray for those people who lost their loved ones, we also remember the cause of this problem. Cause of it is ideological Islam. It is the Quran and also the teachings of Muhammad allows other person to take the life of other people. 22nd May 2017, 23 people died. 22 of them were just people who wanted to enjoy the concert.
Young girls, a lot of young teenagers who've gone to see Ariana Grande at a concert. Really shocking.
We are not surprised to see those kind of things. We are not surprised to see Muslims are taking the life of other people. It comes from the teachings of the Quran. It comes from the teachings of Muhammad.
Yeah. And Muhammad himself ordered his followers to wage jihad against disbelievers. Muhammad himself says in Surah 840, I think, he will fight until the religion is none but for Allah alone. And this is binding on Muslim state. They should continue the fight until the religion is none but for Allah alone. We often get told, oh, this is because it was a time of conflict, that the Muslims were fighting other people in battle. It was like kind of a just war situation. But that's not what the Quran says at all. Over and over again, it says the victim of that your enemy is someone who disbelieves. He's a disbeliever. It's not necessarily because they're involved in a previous conflict, but any kind of political reason.
So, it's been nearly 10 days, Muslims are fasting during the Ramadan. 1.84 billion Muslims are fasting to come close to Allah, fasting to remember their good deeds and increase them. But one of the things Ramadan is known as the time of killing. We look at the Islamic tradition and then we see Battle of Badr took place in the 7th day of Ramadan. We look at the Islamic tradition. We look at the Islamic tradition and then we see again and again Ramadan try to follow this book by taking the life of others.
When we see that, in particular from this hadith, when Muhammad himself marched on Mecca, he marched with 10,000 Muslims in order to conquer Mecca. When did he do it? He did it in Ramadan. Let's read it for you. This is from Bukhari, 1476. The Prophet left Medina for Mecca in the company of 10,000 Muslim warriors in the month of Ramadan. And that was 8.5 years after his migration to Medina. So what a lot of, I think, our politicians and media miss out on is often over and over again in our media we see how it's a wonderful time of fasting and prayer. They miss out on this part that is actually also a time very much associated with jihad and with conquest, according to Muslims, which is why there's so much violence in the month of Ramadan.
So Islamic tradition tells us Ramadan is linked with the killing of people. Also, we look at the history, when we look back last couple of years, we see Ramadan is the time, actually Ramadan is identified in Islamic tradition and in the Quran, not one of the secret months, it is outside of those one of secret months. When we look at the Islam, when we look at the history, we see year after year, killing during the Ramadan always increase. So 2015, do you have the numbers? So 2015, there were 318 attacks and over 2,900 people killed during the holy month of Ramadan. That's a lot of life. That's a lot of life and a lot of life. 2016, 262 attacks and 1,954 people were killed. It's even one is too many. But this is the holy month of Ramadan, where Muslims seek after day after day, prayer after prayer, seek for Allah. It is the time as they seek for Allah, they go and they take life of other people. 2017, 185 Muslim attacks and 1,605 people were killed by Muslims.
And the saddest thing, actually, is that in a lot of these attacks, the victims are the Muslims themselves.
In some of the occasions, not all occasions,
not all but like, you know, Muslims who think other Muslims aren't proper Muslims are the ones often who are in these attacks. But yes, they are against Jews and Christians as well. For example, the Quran also says about Christians that Jews and Christians, sorry, are the worst of creatures.
That's good compliment from Muslims. And it's been only just over 10 days we are into Ramadan. It's been only 10 days Muslims are fasting from food, fasting from water, yet they are not fasting from the taking the life of others. It's been only 10 days, yet there are 53 terror attacks. 53 terror attacks.
And I think, Hatun, as well, you've also got some information, like, what if you live in a Muslim country and you're not Muslim, you don't want to fast, what might happen then?
Oh, well, when you look at what happens in Pakistan, you see people get lashed, people go to prison because they eat publicly. So, if you are in those countries, you must pretend you are fasting, or you must become a Muslim if you don't want to protect.
You also know that there are ex-Muslims, aren't there, who are campaigning for the right not to fast. You're a free country if you want to fast, and of course you can. That's absolutely right. But why is it in Muslim countries do they grant people, non-Muslims, the right as well not to fast if they don't want to?
So, let me remind the numbers again. 2018, only 10 days into Ramadan, we've got 53 Islamic attacks and 217 minimum death because of the Islamic attacks. So, Ramadan is the time of killing. As last year, just before before the Ramadan, 22 life has been taken by a Muslim called Salman Abedi in Manchester. It's only 10 days into Ramadan and over 200 lives has been taken away by Muslims. It is not acceptable, and there is no place for this in this world.
And you know what really breaks my heart more than anything is the idea that Muslims are under the impression that by fasting that is going to bring them closer to God. But actually that's not what Scripture tells us at all. Scripture tells us that basically we are all unclean naturally, and that our righteous acts are just like filthy rags. This is what Isaiah says, Isaiah chapter 64 verse 6. That none of us can cleanse ourselves by praying more, by fasting more, by even doing good deeds. But that isn't enough, that we need a holy God to come and cleanse us himself. We can't wash our hearts from him. That can only be washed by the blood of Jesus. So the peace and the relationship that Muslims are seeking, I think, deep down through all of this, they're not even going to find in Ramadan. They can only find it in the relationship with Lord Jesus. That's what he teaches us in Scripture.
That's why, as 1.84 billion Muslims fast and pray this next 20 days, our prayer is, living God will reveal himself to them. They will repent and come to the cross. They will repent and see the importance of blood of Jesus. They will repent and come to true God.
Amen.